Maintaining the grape quality on organically grown vines at vineyard condition under temperature, climate condition of Konya province. Introduction. In order to maintain the ever-increasing for demand, availability and accessibility, agricultural produce can be improved by increasing the productivity, enhancing distribution, extending the post-harvest quality, and reducing losses. Grapes are one of the most commonly cultivated agricultural products around the world, with a great variability in utilizations such as wine, rice, fresh table grapes, vinegar, and juice. Table grapes, as non-climatic conditions with a relatively low right and physiological activity, are subject to post-harvest losses during storage and transport. There are many effective methods for examining post-harvest quality of grapes: cold storage, drying, just freezing, canning, pickling, or fermenting into wine and or vinegar, or certain ways for conserving the grapes. Recently, there has been a growing interest in traditional foods handled without chemical treatments, with increasing health and environment consideration. Besides, some traditional methods of preserving food have been shown to have a lower energy input and carbon footprint when compared to modern methods. In Turkey, the growers in villages have historical experiences in grape growing and conservation. There is interestingly no available experimental study on this subject. Therefore, the present investigation will perform the study possibilities of maintaining the grape cluster quality on vines and vineyard condition under temperature, climate condition of Konya province. Materials and methods. The study was conducted on 5-7 years old healthy and productive vines of Alphonse Lavelle and Narinci grape cultivars. The experimental vineyard was located in Konya province, Turkey. The vines received the same cultural practice such as wind control, pruning, drip irrigation. After onset of berry ripening, the grapevine canopies were totally covered with curtains up to the end of the study, protect them from bird, hail, and storm. Cluster sampling. Cluster sampling was commenced when the berries attained a total soluble solid volume on commercial and traditional experiences. Periodical samplings were performed with 1 month intervals to reveal the biochemical change and decay in the cluster grapes. A total of 9 cluster for sampling data each cultivar were randomly harvested from the vines. Decay instance. Berry decay was counted by counting the number of decay berries in each cluster, multiplying the total number of decay berries per replication by the average berry size and calculating percentage decay berries. Skin rupture and berry decay force. A total of 45 representative berries pre-treatment were randomly taken from cluster to determine berry detecting skin rupture force. 4 skin ruptures were a berry from each equatorial section, but cradle and jig attached to a forceful gauge, and a gauge was gently pulled above the berry until skin puncture. The first record to puncture the skin berry was recorded as the skin rupture force. The berry from the section was then cut with jig attached to forced gauge, and the raised section was slowly pulled away from the berry until it had the force required to detach each berry from the ratchets from record as berry detachment force. Skin color biochemical quality parameters. The color parameters LG and Hue Angel were measured and equatorial points of the surface 15 berries from each replication with a colorimeter. Total soluble solid content expressed as bricks was measured with a particle refractometer in grape sugar obtained by sweetened berries from each replication. Titratable acidity was determined by titrating. Statistic analysis. Statistic analysis were performed in triplicate on 3 different batches. The mean values and standard deviation calculated. The dates shown in the figures are the average of all reputation, where the error word standard deviation, experimental data were submitted to one-way analysis of variance and statistics tests using so far SPSS 13 for Windows. Results and discussion. During the first 2 months of storage duration, no significant changes were detected decay rates of cultivars. After the second month, pressure increases in bir decay occurred with significant change. At the third analysis, where decay rates of Alphonse Lavin and Naringi grape cultivars were 14.9 and 14% respectively. Decay incidence in berries showed linear increase up to the end of study, which to was 18.4 and 19.5% for Alphonse Lavin and Naringi respectively. Control the decay incidence, one of the prime consideration in storage and hard cultivars products, determined the storage success. Certain traces of cultivation practice have been agreed to delay decay. Cultivar attitude and ecological condition have also significant effect on storage success. In the present study conducted under temperature climate condition of Konya province, decay rates for both cultivars were under 10% for the first 2 months. At the end, 4 months storage duration, although remarkable increments occurred in decay rates of grapes when compared to industrial cold storage, the decay barrier rates were below 20%. As depicted in figure 3, skin rupture force didn't significantly change during the first 2 months. Very skin rupturing force of Alphonse Lavin and culture was remarkably high during the third force. The storage and cooperative prism study post storage crimson seedless grapes. Similar pattern in skin rupture force in Naringi cultivar was also determined, although the values were considerably lower than those of Alphonse Lavin. There were sharp decrease in skin rupture force for both cultivars after the third month. Findings of berry detachment force for cultivars were just similar to those of skin rupture force, as can be seen in figure 4. In Alphonse Lavin, there were no significant change in berry detachment force during the first 2 months and after a slight decrease in drastically decrease in the fourth month. Berry detachment force in Naringi cultivar resulted in a radical decrease during intercal storage. Berry hardiness during storage, transporting and handling of table grapes is an important feature because water loss, pathogen and inoculation and berry shedding favored by berry damage. L and G values gradually decrease during the storage both cultivars. U and G values of cultivars during the time course were opposite from each other, probably due to their berry skin colors. U and G values of Alphonse Lavin tended to increase along with the time course, although the increment magnitude was insignificant after the second one. Conservatively, in Naringi cultivar, Q angel significantly decreases linearly during the storage. Change in berry color due to desiccation, browning, or non-enzymatic reaction is one of the common issues in ability and cover during the storage. SSC in both cultivars underwent a slight but insignificant increase throughout the first 2 months of storage. A general increase in SSC is seen during the cold storage of horticulture produce. After the second month, a significant increase occurred to Alphonse Lavin, although such change was detected after third month to Naringi cultivar. The content of berries progressively decreased in both cultivars during storage with the height decrease in the last month. The pH also underwent a general remarkable decrease along with the storage time similar to results of Saber and Saber who stored the table grapes in cold room. Conclusion. Conventional foods have gained great attention due to their benefits, possibility mating, quality of grapes of Alphonse Lavin and Naringi cultivars on grapes vine without a chemical treatment has been studied under limited condition in temperature climb characteristic. Little losses in quality features were determined in bud cultivars during until the third sampling date. In general, berry resistant features such as skin rupture force and berry detachment force didn't show very drastic change as high as losing the remarkability during the 3 months. Investigations indicated that the grape cluster could be maintained on Grimes Bank under intake condition of the cold autumn seasons in temperature zone by protecting them from the extended damage using the commanding covering materials of the 3 months depending on the response to all cultivars to environmental variables. By the way, the grape growers could improve their digital income with a conventional authentic and cost-effective method, namely intake storage or on-wing storage. Thanks you.